Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is October 22nd, 2019. This is my fourth episode about linear algebra and threading building blocks. In our previous episode, episode 3, numerical differentiation 1 using symmetric difference quotient. If you haven't watched my previous video, please double click this link and watch my previous video about numerical differentiation using symmetric difference quotient method. In this episode, we will learn another numerical differentiation method using Newton's difference quotient. From Wikipedia page, numerical differentiation. In our previous episode, we learned about symmetric difference quotient. In this episode, we will learn Newton's difference quotient method. By using this equation, we will implement the higher order derivative using Newton's difference quotient. I will first explain the mathematical theory behind this equation. Then we will implement this equation in C++ code. This equation is called Newton's difference quotient. If we generalize this difference quotient, then it becomes like this. I will first expand this equation. We will denote f0 x fx. We will drop limit part and this part. Then f1 x equals, I change the order, minus fx and fx plus h, minus fx plus fx plus h. I rewrite this equation, fn x minus 1 k plus n binomial coefficient fx plus kh. In this equation, this part here n is 0, n is 1, n is 2, n is 3, n is 4, n is 5. K in this equation, this is k0, 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 k1, k0, k1, k2, K0, K1, K2, K3, K0, K1, K2, K3, K4. When n is 0, we put plus. When n is 2, we put plus. When n is 4, we put plus. When n is 1, we put minus. When n is 3, we put minus. When n is 5, we put minus. So the first term, n plus k is 0, n plus k is even, then the first term becomes plus. When n plus k, this is k0, k1, n is 1, n plus k is odd, this term is odd, then it becomes minus. So we can say minus, plus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. For simplicity, we define nk wave minus 1 k plus n nk. If we define nk wave like this, this equation becomes very simple like this. Fn x limit h approaches 0 1 over h n sigma k equals 0, n, nk, wave, f, x plus k, h. Now scroll down. When we implement this algorithm, we will implement this part like this. Nk wave equals n plus k modulo 2 is 1. This means if n plus k is odd, then binomial nk, it should be minus. Else, binomial nk, like this. So nk wave represents this term. Now let's expand this power series for F2, like this. F2x sigma k equals 0 to 2k wave fx kh. If we expand it to 0 wave fx, because k is 0, plus 2, 1 wave fx plus h plus 2, 2 wave fx plus 2h. From this equation, n is 2, n is 2, 2, so we need to pay attention to this line. K is 0, k is 0, so this term is 1. K is 1, k is 1, this term is minus 2. K is 2, k is 2, this term is plus 1. So it becomes fx minus 2fx plus h plus fx plus 2h. So second derivative of x, this is the numerator part. In the same manner, we can expand third order of x like this. 3, 0 wave fx plus 3, 1 wave fx plus h plus 3, 2 wave fx plus 2h plus 3, 3 wave fx plus 3h. Now n is 3, so we pay attention to this line. Then it becomes minus fx, because this term is minus, plus 3 fx plus h, because of this term, minus 3 fx plus 2h, because of this term, it is minus 3, plus fx plus 3h. So this part is numerator of third derivative of fx. Now scroll down. F0, fx, f1, fx plus h minus fx, f2, fx plus 2h minus 2 fx plus h plus fx. F3, fx plus 3h minus 3 fx plus 2h plus 3 fx plus h minus fx. We can rewrite like this. Minus fx plus f plus h, and it becomes fx minus 2fx plus h plus fx plus 2h. And this part becomes minus fx plus 3fx plus h minus 3fx plus 2h plus fx plus 3h. So, pay this part and this part and this part. Also this part. Instead of this one and this one, this one, we will use this equation. Like this. F0, fx, f1, fx plus h minus fx. Now f2 is f1 x plus h minus f1 x. Please note that this is two second derivative. We are using this first derivative. Now we can expand this equation like this. We substitute x plus h to here and here. Then f x plus 2h minus f x plus h. This part amounts to this part. Now minus, we substitute this equation is this equation. So fx plus h minus fx. Now if we expand fx plus 2h minus fx plus h, this part here is minus, so minus fx plus h plus fx. We distributed minus to here and to here, so it becomes like this. Then f x plus 2h minus 2 fx plus h plus fx. So it becomes fx minus 2 fx plus h plus fx plus 2h. Then we can say 2-0 wave fx, this part is this part. Now this part becomes plus 2-1 wave fx plus h. So this part is this part. Lastly, 2-2 wave fx plus h. So f2 equals 2-0 wave fx plus 2-1 wave fx plus h, 2-2 wave fx plus h. This is 2h. 2h. So in summation, k equal 0, 2k wave fx plus kh. Now we derived this second order. Well, it becomes k equal 0, 2 minus 1, 2 plus k, 2k, fx plus kh. Now let's consider third order. Again, f0, fx, f1, fx plus h minus fx. We can say f0 because f0 is defined like this. Now f2, f1 x plus h minus f1 x. F3, f2 x plus h minus f2 x. In our previous page, this is f2. We recycle this equation. Fx2 from our previous page, f2x equals fx plus 2h minus 2fx plus h plus fx. Here, we substitute x plus h to this equation and this equation for x. Then, f1, it becomes x plus 2h. X plus 2h. Then, if we substitute x plus h to this equation, minus f1 x plus h. Up to this point, this term amounts to this term. Minus, in our previous page, we computed this term like this in our previous page. So, f x plus 2h minus 2fx plus h plus fx. This term is this term. Please note that this means f1x fx plus h minus fx. Okay? These two equations are the same equation. In this equation, we substitute x plus 2h for x. Then, f1 x plus 2h becomes f x plus 3h minus f x plus 2h. Please note that we substitute x plus 2h for x, and this x, f1, x plus h, we substitute x plus h for x and for x. Then f, x plus 2h minus f, x plus h. Now here, for this equation, we put this equation, we substitute this equation. Then it becomes f x plus 3h minus f x plus 2h, and it has minus here. For this term, we substitute like this, minus fx 2h plus fx plus h. So, this term is this part minus this term, fx plus 2h minus 2x plus h plus fx. Now, we arrange the terms. This term, f x plus 3h, 1, 2, 3. So, minus 3, f, x plus 2h. Now, this term, one term, 2, 3. Because this is minus, this is also minus. So, 3 f x plus h. This term, there is a minus here. So, minus f x. F 3 x becomes, I will rewrite this equation, minus f x plus 3 fx plus h minus 3 fx plus 2h plus fx plus 3h. So it can be written 3 0 wave fx plus 3 1 wave fx plus h plus 3 2 wave fx plus 2h plus 3 3 wave fx plus 3h. Then using sigma k equals 0 3 3k wave fx plus kh. Then f3x equals sigma k equals 0 3 minus 1 k plus n fx 3k fx plus kh. This term is numerator of the third order derivative. Up to this point, we concentrated numerator. Also in this equation, we paid attention to numerator. Now, let's consider about denominator. We will write f0 equals f, f1 equals kf0, f2 kf1, fn minus 1 kfn minus 2 fn kfn minus 1. This is called recurrence relation. This is n, 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 n. This k is not related to n. K is constant with respect to n. Okay, this is constant term. Now we will multiply like this. This is on the left hand side. We multiply all terms together. F0 comes from here. F1 comes from here. F2 comes from here. Then fn minus 1 comes from here times fn equals. Now this term on the right hand side, f times this term kf0 times this term kf1 times, then this term kfn minus 1 this term. Now we will cancel out f0 cancels, f1 cancels, f2 cancels, fn minus 1 cancels. Here we can say f0, f0 cancel, f1, f1 cancel, f2, f2 cancel, fn minus 1, fn minus 1 cancels. On the left hand side, we have fn. On the right hand side, it starts 1, k, 2, k, n, k. So, k, n. And everything cancelled out. Now we have f here. From this equation, let k 1 over h. Then fn becomes hn1f. In this expression, this is n, this h is not related to n. So I applied this reasoning. In FDM or finite difference method, fn x, fn minus 1, x plus h, minus fn minus 1, fx 1 or fn x fn minus 1 x plus h plus fn minus 1 x 2. This pattern occurs all the time. These are called recurrence relation. In such case, fn x sigma k equals 0 n, in case of first equation, minus k plus n n k f x plus k h. In case of second equation, plus this pattern is frequently used. So please remember this equation. Now start Visual Studio Code. Click this button, 04 Newton difference quotient. Hit enter. Click this button, Newton diff.cpp. Hit enter. Control V, define, use, math, defines. Include talk, play, fun, output. .hpp include cmath talk play fun ss stream stream or ndl talk play fun ndl. Please note that we have to include talk play fun ncr mpr hpp for binomial coefficient combination talk play fun ncr mpr combination void test newton difference quotient int main copy this function name paste it function main void Newton diff double x using fptrt double double fptrt func int n equals 1 if n equals 0 return func x else if n equals 1 constant sphere double h 0 0 1 return y is squiggle. It should be double func x plus h minus func x h else combination binomial n 0 double fn m plus 0 modulo 2 equals 1. So if n is odd number, then minus binomial n 0. Otherwise, binomial n0. Then I will use parentheses. This is binomial coefficient times func x plus 0 times h. K equals 0. For int k equals 1. K less than equal to n plus plus k double h h 1 HH H FN equals N plus K modulo 2 equals 1 minus binomial N K S binomial N K times Fung X plus K times H. Now here return FN times, sorry, I will change it like this, HH. This computes HK. Now we test this function. Let's build. Start command prompt. Dir cd 04 Newton difference quotient. We will use GNU compiler G++ STD C++ 17 Newton diff.cpp hit enter. Okay, it fails. Sorry, I made mistake here. It should be plus equal. This part computes k equal 1 through n f x plus k times h. This is summation part. Now here, auto low bound 0, 0, auto upper bound m pi auto delta upper bound minus low bound divide 20 intervals for all x equals low bound x less than or equal to upper bound x plus delta double Newton. We differentiate using this function x sine function. This is for first order. For first order derivative double analytic cosine x sine prime x equals cosine x double diff difference FABS Newton minus analytic. Now we display stream diff diff Newton Newton analytic analytic and there. Now let's build. This is for first order derivative. CLS. So the precision is 5 decimal place. If we increase this value, we can have a better result. We build again A, then we have better result. Now I will copy this part, paste it here, and disable this part. Ctrl K, Ctrl C. Now this is the second order. And if we differentiate sine x, it becomes minus sine x. So it should be minus sine x. Now we test second order. CLS. Wow, this is a huge number. This is absolutely wrong. Please note that Binomial, this returns big unsigned int. It is calling operator. Please note that we declared binomial an instance of combination here, and we are calling function call operator, and this operator returns big unsigned int. So it does not work because we cannot use negative to unsigned int. So I will fix this part like this. Long b binomial n k. Okay, so this is signed. So we put long. Now we can apply minus because this is now signed. You have to be very careful this part. Also, it always returns plus one. So we can modify like this too. Now we build once again. CLS. Now it works. This is second derivative. Okay, the difference is correct up to 6 decimal point. Now let's try third derivative. Copy, Ctrl K, Ctrl C, paste. This is third order derivative. And if we differentiate once again, it becomes minus cosine x. So we also have to fix minus cosine x. Now we are testing third order derivative. Build once again. CLS. In case of third order, it does not seem to be working. The rounding error is too big. Let's try to increase. What decrease? We build again. It's a little bit better, but not very good. We declare the combination here. This is type alias. If you right click, go to definition, then this is class. This is defined like this. The reason this is not a function is for optimization. I will copy this function once again. Copy, paste. I scroll up. I say optimized. I fixed like this. This part is very slow. Once we set the value of n, n is not changing, only k is increasing. So instead of doing this, increase r, then it becomes efficient. It is efficient because it only increment k in binomial nk. This is highly efficient code. And I will also change better. I will delete this part. And I will delete this part. I will re-enable it. Ctrl K, Ctrl U. We are testing second order derivative. Now I will copy this function, paste it here. I disable it. Then it should be, this function should be optimized like this. We are now calling this optimized version. Now let's build. This is second order derivative. It works exactly the same as before. If you want to increase precision, stream, STD, precision, 15. Then 15 decimal places will be displayed. And we will also increase this number. About this interval, I will talk in my next episode or in future episode. Now let's build it. CLS. Mostly six decimal places, correct. I created this combination class based on C++ 17 standard. C++ 20 standard introduces concepts, second coroutine, range. Coroutine and concept significantly improve C++ language. If I use the coroutine, I don't need to create a class called combination. This is class. If we are using coroutine, implementing this combination or binomial coefficient function becomes much simpler. If you want to learn more about coroutine, coroutine in action, please search coroutine in action, then you can watch my video. By watching this video, you can learn about C++ 20 standard coroutine. You can watch this series of video about C++ 20 concept. In my next episode, I will talk about this part and also finite difference coefficient 5-point stencil. I will talk about this method in my next episode. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.